more money, start your own business, better relationships. Do you have goals in your life, but find yourself having no time to work on them?
Bullshit! You're wasting your time left and right. Hi, my name is Andre, and in this video, I'll show you how to use the new Toggl Track to track every minute of your life. More importantly, I'll explain to you why I started doing this and why I think it's beneficial for your life. Finally, I'll share with you my tips on how to structure all your activities in Toggl to get a nice report at the end.
Everything you'll see in this video is using the free version only. You don't need premium for personal tracking. Therefore, we will not cover using Toggl in a team environment. We'll look at both mobile and web.
Let's start with why. Some time ago, I decided to take full control of my life and focus on my goals by simply putting in more hours into what I want to accomplish. Therefore, I wanted to track the time when I'm being productive and working on what's important for me versus when I'm doing nothing valuable at all.
After some research, I decided to give Toggl a try. I wanted a small, handy app with a great UI that excels at tracking time without giving me extra features that I don't need. And as you can see, I'm still with Toggl and I've been using it to track every minute of my life since then.
Toggl Track can show you the truth about how you spend your time as long as you track your time accurately and you don't cheat. Do you really think you've done everything possible and you still can find time to work on your life goals to be happy?
For most people, that is a lie. And let me show you an example. In my best week, I recorded 90 hours of productive work in a week. I thought it was a great number, yet I still spent 17 hours on being lazy in bed, watching bullshit, or simply listening to music. That 17 hours I could have spent working on something more valuable, or simply spending the time with someone I like. And this is the insight that you gain only when you track every minute of your life. Tracking your time with Toggl can show you if your priorities are aligned with how you spend your time. Do you need to hang out with your friends every night? Do you really need to watch the new Netflix series? Or maybe it's commute that's killing you, and you could spend 5 to 10 hours a week on something much better.
In a short moment, I'll show you how to get started with Toggl Track. If you like this video so far, please give it a thumbs up and ask anything you want in the comments below.
Alright, here we are in the mobile app of Toggl Track, and this is how you start with a clean slate. If you tap on the black play button, it will start a timer. This is the default mode to enter your time, and it should be your preferred method if you want to track every minute of your life. Here it's very simple, just enter the name of your activity. I'm going to say podcast recording, and press done when you're finished. As you can see, the timer is already running. Let's fast forward and say that our podcast recording took 1 hour. Once you're finished with your activity, simply press the red button to stop the timer, and this is going to create a new entry in your Toggl Track account. Let's start another activity, which I'll call podcast editing. Once again, I'll speed up this demo to make the editing last 30 minutes. Let's say that after we're done with the editing, we want to go back to recording, and this is something that you will be using almost all the time. Once you fill your Toggl account with your typical activities, you will simply continue them, and there are a few ways to do this. One of them is to tap the play button on the activity that you want to continue. Your second option is to simply swipe right. You can see that all the activities that we did today are grouped together. This is indicated by the number next to the activity. In our case, podcast recording has 3 time entries today. When you tap the number, you will expand the group and see all the individual entries. The last 2 entries we did for podcast recording were just a couple of seconds to show you how to continue activities. So let's get rid of them. To delete an entry, you simply swipe left. Here you need to be aware that if you swipe left on the whole group of entries, you will delete all of them. If you want to delete only some entries from a group, you first have to expand the group and then delete individual time entries one by one. Now that we know how to delete entries, let's learn how to edit them. And editing will be very important to you, especially when you're starting out, because I guarantee to you that you will keep forgetting to stop the timer and start a timer for the next activity that you're actually doing. So in many cases, you will stop the timer later and then you will need to manually adjust the time. To edit an entry, all you have to do is tap on it. Here you can see the details of the time entry with the start time and end time, and the duration that the system calculated automatically. When you tap any of the times, it will bring up this interactive wheel, which kind of reminds me of an iPod, and you basically drag and drop the start or stop time. You can also manually input the start and stop time. This is useful if you need to make larger adjustments. When you're done with your changes, just press save and your entry will be updated. In the beginning, I mentioned the preferred method to track your time using the timer mode. Let's check the other option, which is called the manual mode. To enter the manual mode, all you have to do is tap and hold the black play button. The manual mode is very similar to the editing mode, so it doesn't start a timer, but you can manually enter which activity started when and when they finished. I do not recommend using the manual mode if your goal is to track every minute of your life. You need to keep running the timer to reflect the actual thing that you're doing at the moment. Now that we've covered the basics and we have three entries in our Toggl account, let's have a quick look at the reports. We have 1 hour and 52 minutes logged for today, and as we scroll down, there's a big surprise. This donut chart shows that there is no project. Projects in Toggl group similar activities, and they allow you to get better reports. Let's go back and start a new activity. This time we're watching Stranger Things. Before you press done, you can tap the folder icon, which represents projects. That adds the add symbol, which gives us the opportunity to create a new project. This one I'm going to name as Netflix. You can pick a color for your project. I usually prefer the black color for anything that's not valuable. At the end, we hit create and confirm the new activity with done. The timer is running and you can now see that this activity belongs to the Netflix project. Fast forward and let's say we spend 45 minutes watching Stranger Things under the Netflix project. It is important that every activity you track belongs to a project. So now we're going to fix the previous two entries. I'm going to edit the podcast recording first, and here we can see the folder icon again, and I'll use it to create a new project that I'll call Creative. And for all my creative work, I like to use the red color. We create a project, save the edit, and now we see that the podcast recording entry belongs to the creative project. Now in a very similar way, I'm going to assign the podcast editing entries to the creative project. Because the creative project already exists, we don't have to create it again. We can simply select it from the list of already existing projects. Now that we have two different projects defined, let's go back to the reports and see how the donut chart changed. Beautiful! You can see the chart is using the colors we defined for the project, and it's splitting the donut into the projects based on how much time we spend on each. Next, I'm going to quickly create a new entry for a new activity, which will be the job, and I'm going to assign it to a newly created project called job as well. The reason why these are called the same way is that I don't need to track more details from my job, I just need it to be there as a project so that I can use it in reports. Let's go back to the reports quickly and look at the donut chart. As expected, it is sliced into three parts: job, creative, and Netflix. But here's the thing, to me, creative and doing my job, those are both productive things. So how can I easily get a report of how productive I was so that I don't have to calculate it manually? The answer lies in using the client as the second level of grouping, and I'll show you how it works in the web version. So this is the web interface at track.toggl.com, and on the main page you can see all the entries that we did from the mobile app, perfectly synced. Let's go to the reports, and here you will see that the web version offers more types of grouping. You can group by the projects, which is the same one that we see in the mobile app, but you also have the option to group by users and by clients. You won't need the user grouping at all, because we're focusing on tracking our time only, so let's focus on the client grouping. Each project that you create can belong only to one client, therefore it creates this hierarchy of activities that we track in Toggl. On top, you would have the client, which can have several projects, and then you can track individual activities under those projects. As an example, we can have productive as a client, and under that we can have few projects like job, learning, or creative. which are all productive, and then under those projects, we track individual activities like podcast editing, podcast recording, or reading a book. Another example would be if you focus on relationships. You can have a client which is about relationships, and under that client, you would have projects like family, friends, or colleagues. In our demo, we have no client so far, so let's fix it. I'll go to the clients page and simply add two clients. One productive and one no value. Now all that is left to do is to assign the projects we created earlier to the right client. And here I'm telling Toggl that creative project and job project both belong to the productive client. And Netflix is of course no value. When we go back to the reports here in the web version, now we'll be able to see the grouping by the client as we want it. With a few little changes that we introduced in the web version, let's switch back to the mobile app and see if anything changed. I'll refresh the app by swiping down, and now you can see that next to the project name like Netflix, creative or job, we have the name of the client like productive or no value. Now when we start a timer for a new activity, which will be script writing, and we assign it to the creative project, it will automatically go to the productive client. You can also add a client in the mobile app, and I'm going to quickly demonstrate it on a new activity, which I'll simply call music. I'll add it to a new project called Relax, and this is where I can assign it to the no value client. And we'll give this one 20 minutes. If you go to the reports in your mobile app, you will still see only grouping by the project. Therefore, we're going back to the web version where we can see our entries grouped by the client. Besides the summary report, we also have a detailed report and a weekly report. The detailed report is great for making bulk edits, while the weekly report gives you a nice overview for each day in a week. Speaking of reports, I want to show you the calendar view. This is my real account, by the way, so you'll see a lot more data. When you're at the timer page, you can switch to the calendar view using this icon on top right. This feature was previously only available in the mobile app, but now we finally have it in the web version as well. It's a very visual report of what you did every day, minute by minute. Perhaps it can help you find patterns in your life or structure your day in a more organized way. Congratulations, you made it to the last part. This is where I'm going to share with you how my own Toggl account looks like and how I structure each activity that I'm doing throughout the day. In fact, I'll show you two different ways. One is from 2019 when I started using Toggl, and the other one is the most up-to-date that I'm using nowadays. First, let me show you the original structure, which may be more simple and it's very much aligned with what you've seen so far in this video. I had 4 clients total: no value, productive, relationships, and sleep. Sleep only had one project called sleep as well, and this is where I was tracking my time sleeping. Sleep is important, and that's why I had sleep as an individual client separated from the others. Then I had 2 important clients: productive and relationships. Productive represented my personal goals and the time here was supposed to make my life better. You can find projects like job, learning, creating content, sport, and dancing here. I used admin for personal admin work like emails, finances, and so on. And then I had survival for cooking, cleaning, groceries, and washing myself. These are things that don't necessarily push me forward, but they're the basics to keep us going. I wanted to focus on my relationships with people a lot more, which is why I had a separate client for that. You can do this for any area of your life that's important to you and you want to put more effort into it. The final client is no value, where I mostly put time spent on watching YouTube or TV series or just listening to music as my way of relaxing. I had others project for activities that were random and I couldn't fit them into any other project. The new structure is slightly different when it comes to clients. I still have sleep and no value as clients. Nothing has changed there. The new clients are called future, joy, and one combined joy and future. Now, what does it mean? I'm using the future client to track all the activities that are important for my future, but I don't necessarily enjoy doing them. The joy client is the opposite. It's something I really enjoy doing, but it doesn't directly create a better future for me. You can think of these two as long-term versus short-term rewards. The final client is joy and future. As you can imagine, this is me doing something important for my future, and I really enjoy doing it at the moment. This is where I want to eventually spend most of my time, and I think everyone should strive towards this. To give you an example, let's say I'm creating this new video about Toggl Track. Before that, it would all go to one creative project under productive client. With the new system, I'm tracking separately activities that I don't like doing, like script writing. This would go under the future project. On the other hand, video editing is something I enjoy doing, so it would go under joy and future. The idea here is that the future-only activities will one day be delegated to someone else, while I'll only focus on the things I really enjoy doing. Another tip is about finding time for your goals. Unless you sleep too much, you'll first want to eliminate the no-value activities. If you still don't have enough time, looking at joy would be your next step. Say no to short-term benefits and focus on building a better future. Let's quickly run through the projects. In the future, we have the familiar admin and survival. These things are routine tasks, and I don't like routine much, so no joy here. I also have some learning here, even though in most cases I enjoy learning. Then I have well-being. For example, doing physiotherapy exercises is important, but I don't enjoy it. The final three projects are related to my website and my two podcasts, so all the creative work that I don't enjoy goes to these categories. Instead of having just one creative project under future, I decided to split it for each project. Under joy, we have relationships. This is purely to hang out with people and be socially active. Relax is now under joy, and I use it mostly for listening to music. So it's not a no value anymore, but I still want to limit the time that I spend here. I play a game on a stream almost every day to have some fun and to get energized for the evening work session. Joy and future. Here you'll see most of the projects from future, but this time it's for activities that I enjoy doing as well. The letters in the brackets, by the way, indicate a client in the project name, so I can easily distinguish between, let's say, well-being that I don't enjoy doing versus well-being that I do enjoy doing. The new project here is dancing, which I definitely enjoy. And then I have a life project, which is basically me strategizing about my life, reviewing my notes about who I am, who I want to be, setting goals for the next day, and reviewing my progress. And that's it. That's how I use Toggl to track every minute of my life. Once you master the basics, just follow my few key tips. Make sure your timer is always running 24/7. Track your time accurately and don't cheat. You're only lying to yourself. Think of a good structure for your activities so that you can get practical reports. Finally, when you have good reports, face the truth, look at where you waste your time, and take an action. Start doing what really matters to you.
Hey, thanks for sticking with me until the end of this video. I hope you find this content useful, and tracking every minute of your life will help you achieve your goals and what's important for you. I want to let you know that I started a new video series called the Accountability Journal. This is where I provide productivity tips and I share with you how I did last week and what are my goals for the next week. And part of this video series is sharing my data from Toggl Track. So if you like these tools, if you want to really take more control of your life, I think the series would be good for you. Thank you.